Hello students, it's warm welcome to Sri Pragya Public School online classes. From these online classes, you make the much advantage on your future. So, today's our topic is brain. As you know, the brain is the most prominent part or important coordinate control center of the human nervous system. The human nervous system is at two types, central nervous system and peripheral nervous system. So brain is the part of central nervous system. The brain is soft organ of the body and comprises protected in the three meninges or layer of the brain. The layers of the brain is A, D, P. A means arachnoid, D means dura mater, and P means pia mater, in which the dura mater is the outermost layer of the brain, and the brain is protected inside the skull, and the part of skull in which the brain is protected known as cranium. So these are the cranial layers of the brain. Dura mater is the protective, first protecting covering of the brain, and between the pia mater and arachnoid, between these two layers, the liquid is flow that is known as cerebrospinal fluid. This cerebrospinal fluid is essential for the circulate all the messages all over the brain. And the regions of the brain is divided into three parts, that are, first is forebrain, that is the most prominent part and the largest part of the brain. The smallest part of the brain is midbrain, and the last part is known as hindbrain. The first part, forebrain, is located the topmost of the body and divided into two parts, that is cerebrum and diencephalon. Cerebrum is the most prominent part of the brain. It is comprises two hemispheres. Each hemisphere further divided into two parts, that are, the outer part is known as cortex and the inner part is known as medulla. The outer part is cortex, filled with the liquid, is gray matter, and the inner part, medulla, is filled with the white matter. What is its importance? The cortex part comprises the body of neuron, means nerve cell. And as we know, neuron extended part is known as axons, that comprises or made up the medulla part. These two liquids together is related to the cerebrospinal fluid, that is located in the brain and transfer all the messages along the body. Now diencephalon comprises two lobes that are known as, upper part is thalamus, and the base of the thalamus is known as hypothalamus. The thalamus is related to the two types of neurons or two types of nerves, that are sensory nerves and the motor nerves. The motor nerves convey the messages, sensory nerves receive the messages. These two nerves are control the our reflex action. So we can say thalamus is the part which feel us the all sense organs activities, and the hypothalamus is most important part of our brain, because it control firstly the temperature of body, sleep wake cycles, thirst and hunger. Secondly, it secretes the many hormones, especially the two hormones is as ADH, anti-diuretic hormone for controlling or balancing of our body, and secondly is oxytocin. The third important function of the hypothalamus, because of this function, the hypothalamus is known as master gland, and the master gland is pituitary. So it is the control center of pituitary gland. Now the smallest part is midbrain. Before going to start the midbrain, as we know commonly, what are the function of the forebrain? As you can learn, it's by the CD. As you know, CD is the recorder or work as the memory. So it is the memory center, determination center, desire center, thinking power, all recognition, recollection, all the patterns, all the functions related to the forebrain. And the midbrain, what are the function of midbrain? We can say the midbrain is AV. What is the mean of AV? Because midbrain is made up of four lobes. That four lobes is known as corpora quadrigemina. Quadri means four. These corpora quadrigemina, in which two lobes are related to the auditory functions, or the two lobes known as for the visual actions. So it is the center for the audio visual organs of our body. Now the hindbrain. The hindbrain comprises the two main parts, in which first part is cerebellum, which is known as little cerebrum. Cerebrum is the largest part, prominent part of the brain, and second largest part of the brain is cerebellum. Why cerebellum is important? The cerebellum, or we can say hindbrain, has the PRA actions. Mean of PRA? P means the body posture, which is controlled by the cerebellum. While we are talking, while we are walking, while we are actioning, our body equilibrium controlled by the cerebellum. The next part is brain stem. Most of the exams, the question arises, what is brain stem? So the brain stem consists two parts, that are pons. The pons situated between the midbrain, and the last part of the brain is medulla oblongata. The pons is related to the respiration, and the medulla oblongata related to all the actions, either of sudden jerk or reflex actions. Sudden jerk means the vomiting, sneezing as usual. So further we are going to study it's by the structure of the brain. The structure of brain, we are going to start from the brain stem. As I told to you, the brain stem consists two parts, that are pons. The pons is situated between the two parts, that are midbrain and medulla oblongata. The medulla oblongata is extended in the form of spinal cord. The spinal cord is the part of peripheral nervous system which is come out from the skull as a whole, known as foramen of magnum. The brain has its three coverings. How it is? It is just look like a tree shape. The outermost covering is known as, what is the outermost covering? That is dura mater. The first covering is dura mater, second is arachnoid, and third is pia mater. The pia mater means the coverings or foldings along with the whole part of the brain. The brain itself, the forebrain, divided into two cerebral hemispheres, which is jointed by the tract of nerve fibers, that is known as corpus callosum. Inside the two layers, between two layers, arachnoid and pia mater, the fluid is flow, that is known as cerebrospinal fluid. So we can say the forebrain is made up of two parts, cerebrum, that is the, as we are seeing here, is the largest part of our brain, and the brain is soft organ. It is protected inside the, yes, skull. And the cover of the skull in which the brain is protected, known as cranium. So inside the cranium, first the three layers of the brain, and inside the three layers, the first four brain is divided into two parts, that is cerebrum, largest part, and the secondly diencephalon. As you are seeing here, diencephalon consists divided into two parts, thalamus and hypothalamus. So there are two lobes, in which the first lobe is thalamus, and thalamus related to the, yes, our sense organs. And the secondly is, the base of the thalamus is hypothalamus. That is the important part of body, as control the endocrine glands, secrete the hormones, all the function, temperature, sleep-wake cycle, thirst, hunger, etc. And all the recognition, thinking power, desire controlled by the cerebrum only. Now, the midbrain. As we are written here, the midbrain is AV. The AV means the audio and visual functions controlled by the this part. This is a midbrain. Midbrain and the medulla oblongata has the part is known as pons. Here, we are observing the smallest part of the brain, that is known as hindbrain. Below the cerebrum, the part is located known as hindbrain. Hindbrain also divided into two parts, that is first part is cerebrum. So it's a cerebellum, second largest part of the brain, and the brain stem. The brain stem included the pons and medulla oblongata. The pons is the pneumotaxis center, which control the our respiration, and medulla oblongata is control the sudden jerks and reflex action with the help of spinal cord. So the brain is not overloaded or not feel the burden. We are doing our work regularly without stress. This is the structure of human brain. Thank you.